Okay, so I think it's a very brief material about how to address goals. So what you need to memorize is basically the most important part is Bapak or Ibu when you want to say sir or ma'am, which is in a business situation, academic or formal situation. And then for people around your age, you can say saudara or saudari. And you, if you know their name, you can put them before their name. But if you don't know their name, you can simply say saudara. Saudara is for male and saudari is for female. Okay, so that's it for the first part. And then we're going to be moving on to verbs, which is very important on making sentences, especially about activities in Indonesian. Here's a table that shows the form of how verb in Indonesian works. For example, here we have the word bekerja, and bekerja means works. Here's the difference between a few types of bekerja. For example, in the first what's it called, like row, we have dia bekerja. So dia could mean he or she, right? Dia bekerja means he works, like right now he works. And it's not really specified, but it's more like present tense. And then dia sedang bekerja. Sedang, the word sedang here specifies that he is currently working right now. So he is working. Dia sedang bekerja. So that's the only difference between dia bekerja, he works, and dia sedang bekerja, he's working. And if it's in the form of past tense, we only need to add the word sudah. And sudah, if you notice, like yesterday I was talking about how Indonesian words don't really have the form of past tense. Like we don't have to change the verb into past tense. The only thing we need to do is to add the word sudah, which means already. So sudah literally means already. So it's like he already worked, but it's translated to he has worked, he had worked, he has been working, or he had been working. It's all the same. It's just ya sudah bekerja, like he already worked. So the verb itself doesn't change, but to specify that something has been done, we only add the word sudah. And for future tense, we have the word akan. And akan means will. Okay.
Hey, hello everyone.
Hi.
I'm
Hey. So, how's it going?
pretty well, pretty late, pretty well. I'm kind of late because I was eating. It's pretty early here.
Yeah, I got it.
Sorry for that.
Okay. So I might repeat a little bit for you on this
Sure,
part.
thank you.
Pleasure. We were discussing about the verb in Indonesian, and here's a table about like structure how verb works in Indonesian. So like in the first part we have a sentence dia bekerja, and it means he works. And what differentiates dia bekerja with dia sedang bekerja is that the word sedang specifies that someone, or in this case, it's he or she, is currently working or is currently doing something. So yeah, dia bekerja means he works, and dia sedang bekerja means he is working. And here we have something that specifies that the verb was already done in the past. like he has worked, he had worked, he has been working, and he had been working. We have the sentence, dia sudah bekerja, and I wrote a note here that sudah literally means already. So in Indonesian, we don't change the verb into any kind of future or present or past form. It stays the same, bekerja, but to specify the time, to show the time, we add the word sudah, which means already. And here, we have another sentence, which is dia akan bekerja. So it means he will work, or he will be working, or he will have worked. The word akan specifies that something will be done. So like I said, the verb bekerja, it stays the same. And yeah, so you guys can read this from dia bekerja.
Dia bekerja. Dia sedang bekerja.
And this one.
Dia sudah bekerja.
Yeah.
Dia akan bekerja.
Cool. And Matt, you can read it.
So, dia bekerja. Dia sedang bekerja. Dia sudah bekerja. And dia akan bekerja.
Okay, good job. So, like, yeah, we might notice that the basic sentence here is dia bekerja. And when you want to specify, like, right now, we just need to add the word sedang. And has or had or has been or had been, we only need to add the word sudah. And will, we only need to add the word akan. So yeah, I guess you can take notes on the usage of these essential words. And it works as well for the other subjects, like example, saya bekerja, I work, or I am working, aku, saya sedang bekerja, or aku sedang bekerja, or I have worked, saya sudah bekerja, or I will work, saya akan bekerja. Okay. We're gonna have a few lists of, like, I know it's an overwhelmingly long list of verbs here. I would like to give the examples of how to read it, but after this we're gonna take a look at an article to learn about more sentence examples. So like here we have verbs like belajar, to study, mengajar, to teach, meminjam, to borrow, meminjamkan, to lend, menulis, to write, bermain, to play, mengobrol, to talk, terlambat, late, membolos, to skip the class, bertanya, to ask, menjawab, to answer, mengangkat tangan, to raise hand, memahami, to learn or to understand. Like, these are a few words that you guys will be using, but I think I will stop sharing the screen and we'll moving on to another page. Okay, here. Yeah, here we go. Here's where I took those lists from. But here we have more complete examples of verbs. For example, the verb tidur, it means to sleep. Example could be saya tidur di kasur. I sleep. Saya, I, tidur, sleep. di on kasur, the bed. And below this we have the word tidur siang. So what distinguish between tidur and tidur siang is that it's the same, it's sleeping, but tidur siang specifies for taking a nap. And if you remember, siang actually means afternoon or day. So why do we say tidur siang? And it's because most people only like take a nap or like sleep in the short term during the afternoon. So for taking a nap or sleeping at the afternoon, we use the word tidur siang. Like saya tidur siang di sofa. I'm taking a nap on the couch. Okay, you guys can read this one, the first sentence.
Tidur. Oh, the sentence. All right. Saya tidur di kasur.
Okay.
Saya tidur di kasur.
Great. And the next one. Saya tidur siang di sofa.
Saya tidur siang di sofa.
Yeah, and the next word we have for bangun tidur, and bangun tidur means to wake up. So the sentence here is saya bangun tidur setiap jam 5 pagi. Saya or aku means I, and bangun tidur means wake up. Setiap. Actually, setiap means every, so like it's like every 5 o'clock in the morning. Setiap jam lima pagi. And yesterday we were talking about time telling, so like jam lima means 5 o'clock, pagi means morning. So jam lima pagi, 5 o'clock in the morning. Saya bangun tidur setiap jam lima pagi. Okay, can you try reading this one?
Saya bangun tidur setiap jam 5 pagi.
Great.
Saya bangun tidur setiap jam 5 pagi.
Okay, great. And the next one we have menonton TV means to watch TV. So menonton means watch. Saya selalu menonton TV sepulang sekolah. I always watch TV after school. Saya, I, and selalu. Selalu means always. Menonton TV, watch TV. Sepulang. Sepulang, it literally means during the return. But in the context of sepulang sekolah, because sekolah means school, so sepulang sekolah means after school or on the return of school. Saya selalu menonton TV sepulang sekolah. Okay, you guys can read this one.
Saya selalu menonton TV sepulang sekolah.
Oh, okay.
So, saya selalu menonton TV sepulang sekolah.
Great. Okay. So, I noticed that this is like the late tutors in the morning. And, okay, the next verb we have the word mandi. It means take a shower. For example, saya mandi sebelum berangkat ke sekolah. So saya mandi means I take a shower, and sebelum means before. After here, it's written as sepulang, but it can also be sesudah. I think I will make a note somewhere about this word, but here, before. in Indonesian we say sebelum. So I take a shower before saya mandi sebelum berangkat. Berangkat means go to, ke sekolah, to school. We can use the word berangkat. We can also use the word pergi. But like berangkat, it's more like we're starting to go to somewhere, and like we're going from home. Like we're going from the first place after we wake up. We use the word berangkat. Saya mandi sebelum berangkat ke sekolah. Okay, you can repeat after me. Saya mandi sebelum berangkat ke sekolah.
Saya mandi sebelum berangkat ke sekolah.
Saya mandi sebelum berangkat ke sekolah.
Okay, great guys. And then we have the word belajar or to study. Here we have the sentence, saya belajar setiap sore. Setiap means every, so saya belajar, I study setiap every, sore means evening. So saya belajar setiap sore, I study every evening. Okay, your turn.
Saya belajar setiap sore.
Saya belajar setiap sore.
Okay, good. And then membaca, reading or to read. Okay, here we use another subject. So instead of I, we use he. And in the form of ayah saya. And ayah saya means my dad. Ayah means dad and saya means my. Ayah saya membaca koran saat istirahat. My dad read newspaper on his break time. So, membaca means to read, and koran means newspaper. Saat means on or like while, like during or while, we say saat. Istirahat means break time. So we have ayah saya membaca koran saat istirahat. You can repeat this sentence.
Ayah saya membaca koran saat istirahat.
Good.
Ayah saya membaca koran saat istirahat.
Okay, so for this membaca, the C, you read it like CH, so membaca. Not pembaca. Okay, and the next verb we have sarapan or to eat breakfast. Here the sentence is saya jarang melewatkan sarapan di pagi hari. Okay, so here we have the word jarang, and jarang means rarely. Saya jarang melewatkan sarapan. I rarely skip to eat breakfast. And melewatkan, it means skip, to skip. And sarapan means breakfast. So saya jarang melewatkan sarapan. I rarely skip breakfast di pagi hari, in the morning. Pagi means morning. And yeah, di pagi hari, in the morning. Okay, you guys can read this.
Saya jarang melewatkan sarapan di pagi hari.
Saya jarang melewatkan sarapan di pagi hari.
Great. Okay, we have 5 more basic verbs. Makan siang, it means to eat lunch. So like sarapan means breakfast and makan siang means lunch. Example here, we use the word she in the form of ibu or mom. Ibu menyiapkan untuk makan siang. Mom prepares the lunch, or mom prepares to eat the lunch. Ibu menyiapkan, it means, menyiapkan means prepares. Ibu menyiapkan untuk makan siang. Mom prepares to eat lunch. Okay, you guys can read this.
Ibu menyiapkan untuk makan siang.
Ibu menyiapkan untuk makan siang.
Okay, cool. And then makan malam, it means dinner. So like sarapan is like breakfast in the morning, and makan siang, lunch, and malam, like makan malam means eat dinner or to eat at night. Kami sedang makan malam. We are having dinner. So remember in our previous table in the PPT, we had a note that specifies the difference between kami makan malam and kami sedang makan malam. So if we say kami makan malam, it means we have dinner. But when we say kami sedang makan malam, the word sedang becomes a specification that we are currently having dinner, like we are having dinner. So yeah, kami sedang makan malam.
Kami sedang makan malam.
Kami sedang makan malam.
Okay, cool. And we have the last three. We have memasak or to cook. For example, ibu kami sedang memasak makan malam. Ibu kami means our mother, because kami means our. So ibu kami, our mother, sedang is, or like is currently memasak, cooking, makan malam, dinner. So like our mother is cooking dinner. Okay, I think the writer is missing the word dinner here, but yeah. Ibu kami sedang memasak makan malam. Okay, you guys can read it.
Kami sedang memasak makan malam.
Ibu kami sedang memasak makan malam.
Okay, cool guys. And the last two, mencuci, to wash. Kami harus mencuci pakaian kami sendiri. Kami means we, and harus means have to or should or must. I explained in the yesterday's material that the word harus is flexible. We can use it in three contexts: have to, must, or should. We only use one word, harus. Kami harus mencuci pakaian kami sendiri, and mencuci means to wash. Pakaian means clothes, and kami means our own. So kami means our, and the word sendiri, it specifies, or like it emphasizes own. So like if we say pakaian kami, it means our clothes. But when we say pakaian kami sendiri, it means our own clothes. So here sendiri stands for the word own. So yeah, kami harus mencuci pakaian kami sendiri. Okay, your turn.
Kami harus mencuci pakaian kami sendiri.
Great.
Okay, so kami harus mencuci pakaian kami sendiri.
Okay, great. The last one. The word tinggal. tinggal means to live in. For example, kami tinggal di sebuah rumah kecil yang terletak di pedesaan. Okay, a long sentence. Kami means we, and tinggal means live. Di means in, sebuah means a, so like a. Di sebuah, a small house. Di sebuah rumah kecil. If we say just we live in small house, we just say kami tinggal di rumah kecil. But if we add we live in a small house, like it specifies that it's one object, a small house, we add the word sebuah. Di sebuah rumah kecil, yang means that is, terletak means located, di means in pedesaan means village. So, kami tinggal di sebuah rumah kecil yang terletak di pedesaan. We live in a small house that is located in a village. Okay, you guys can read it.
Kami tinggal di sebuah rumah kecil yang terletak di pedesaan.
Okay, good job.
Kami tinggal di sebuah rumah kecil yang terletak di pedesaan.
Great job. Okay, so okay, we have a little practice here, and it's currently 8:40. Okay, 8:40. So I'm gonna give you guys about 20 minutes or 30 minutes. I think 30 minutes is okay if you guys are free. So 30 minutes, you guys can choose, five words from this table. You can take any of these and make a sentence out of five words from this table. So yeah, I think you guys can start making it. And if you guys want to take note, you guys can ask me also. Like, if you need more time to take note, I will definitely.
Okay.
You guys can. Yeah. I will share.
So wait, which ones are the verbs?
Sorry.
What's the list of the verbs?
Yeah. You guys can make sentence. From here, like five sentence from five
words. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And if there's a question or anything, feel free to go to the chat room or just ask. Yeah.